bracelet and ring using blanks and UV resin. All right, so I'm gonna go over what we are going to be using today so that you guys know. First, we're gonna be using the Resin Rockers UV resin, obviously. We will be using some clay pieces. We're gonna be using Halloween clay pieces today. Those are going to serve as the charm in the middle of the bracelet. So when we're done with our bracelet, it will look similar to this for the background. And it will have the charms in the middle. So it'll be actually really cool. I've made a few of these and they make great gifts. They're super easy and they're quick to make. I'm gonna be teaching, you know, how to create the bracelet itself using UV resin and glitter, adding these clay pieces, and then I'm going to show her how to add a charm to it just for some extra bling. And then I'll also show her how to make a ring. So this is just a costume jewelry ring. We have everything you see here is available in our shop. So if you guys have questions on finding stuff, please let us know and we'll be more than happy to help. And the best part is I will show you how to level it out using this easy clamp that we use, that we sell. You can get them here, you can get them at the Dollar Tree, but they're super easy to use. And then we're going to be using our mini silicone cup and our silicone brushes, obviously. This is called a stay put mat. So this is what we use to do a lot of our backless bezels. And it's easy to use with blanks of any kind. So if you're working with an acrylic blank and you want it to stay somewhere and not move around, instead of picking it up and trying to move it, you can actually set it and press it into this mat and it'll kind of stay there. And then you're only working with the mat. So you can pick the mat up, put it into your lamp, and you can rotate the mat without picking up your piece and touching it. So it is really, really handy to have. So I'm gonna teach Liz how to use that today as well. So first we're gonna start with our bracelet. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna lay the bracelet out in the mat so that it's in a circle because you want enough room to work on it. So we're gonna do it just like that. And then you're gonna press it down into the mat to get it as level as possible. So now we're gonna go into our glitter. We definitely want to do something that is not iridescent because iridescent means that you're going to be able to see through it. So we're going to work with matte glitter, so we can choose from the electricity orange. I love the fluorescence, the neons are really fun. Mm-hmm. The chameleon glitter, this is Demogorgon. Can't go wrong with Demogorgon.
Yep.
Purple people eater, I love this one also. This is a color shift as well. Ruby throat is always a really good one, especially if you want other pieces to pop. So this is also a really good one. That's a good one. And Electric Avenue, which is the green.
Ooh.
So these are all really good Halloween choices if you're making something spooky. So that being said, what would you like to go with for this bracelet?
I think I'm gonna go with the Electric Avenue. The
Electric
green.
Avenue, you got it.
I love it.
Now you can pick two if you want to do different colors.
Okay.
It's totally up to you.
What about what would it look like if I mixed the electricity orange with it?
So I would do let's see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I would do every other.
Oh,
so
gotcha.
I can give you, we can get three done, so we'll do every other, and then we'll do that in one color, and then we'll put a different color down.
Four. Okay.
Does that sound good?
Yeah,
okay.
Great.
Now, do you have an idea on the clay that you're going to use?
Ooh, it's a really tough choice.
So she's choosing from the Nightmare Before Christmas ones. This is just this got like Dracula, jack-o'-lanterns. This is like a Mickey Mouse inspired bat mix. Which is really cute. The jack-o'-lanterns, and then the spooky mix.
I like the spooky mix.
The spooky mix, that's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
And then eyeballs, obviously, is another really good choice. Okay, so I am going to do the eyeballs because I think they're so cute, and I've done them in barrettes, and they turn out so nice. So that's what I'm gonna go with. So I'm going to do, let's see, with my eyeballs, I got pink, green. I'm gonna do orange with mine. First things first, we are going to put a little bit of resin in our silicone cup. So go ahead and fill it about a third of the way. And then just make sure that you recap your resin in between, because it can cure with the light. So you just want to make sure that it's got the cap on at all times. Because this is a matte, and I'm all about the bling. So I think I'm going to go with this purple people eater.
There you go.
All right, so you're just going to take a little bit of glitter, about a half of a spoonful is really all you need.
Okay.
And add that to, I'm going to add a little more because it actually is staticky. So it's sticking to my spoon. And then we're going to use our silicone brush to mix them. I am going to add a little bit of Laffy Taffy grape, which is one of my favorites, to the Purple People Eater. Perfect. So let's use our silicone brush. So this, the end that I like to use for mixing is the flat side.
Okay.
Because you can kind of use it like a spatula. So you're just gonna gently mix in your glitter.
It's looking good.
Yeah. So you'll have a nice, like, if you don't want it too runny, I did bathe it beforehand. I just put it in a little bit of warm water just to warm it up because it was a little chilly in here. But this is like the perfect consistency and it's super blingy and I love this.
Mm-hmm.
Then for spreading, I like to use the other side. So you're just gonna pick up a little bit of resin with the other end. Okay. And this is a slow process because it's a very small blank. So just pick up a little bit and you're just gonna dab it into the blank. And you don't wanna fill it because we need enough room for those eyeballs or whatever clay you're using over there. I guess you're using the spooky mix, so you're gonna have all kinds of stuff going on over there. So you only want enough to maybe fill it halfway. Because the other thing is after you put your clay in and we go ahead and cure this first layer, we want enough room to put a top coat on because that's what gives it that really pretty domed appearance like this. So just adding your resin in, trying to keep the blank as even as you can. Okay, so this is looking good, you guys. All right, so we're filling this in. And you guys, these blanks are super durable. They are stainless steel, so they're hypoallergenic, and they're relatively inexpensive. So if you're doing gifts for people, you can easily do them for a reasonable cost. And you can do anything. You can add any clay to them. You can just do glitter. This is what it looks like if you just do glitter. So it really is an easy project. Okay, so I'm gonna turn my mat a little bit and it's starting to level out really nicely. So I'm just gonna kind of tip my blanks a little bit just to make sure that it's nice and level before I stick in my clay. And that looks good. So we are gonna use tweezers. This is what you're going to use to pick up your clay pieces that you choose.
Excellent.
So now that this looks nice and level, I'm gonna go ahead and choose my eyeballs. Yes, it's jewelry day. So the white silicone square is called the Stay Put Tray. So it fits perfect into your lamp, which is nice. And you can also pick your lamp up and bring it to your piece, which is nice also. So now that this is all nice and level, because I don't want to waste this glitter, we're going to go ahead and we're going to fill our ring at the same time. So what you want to do with your ring, so you're going to take your little clippy duty, duty man, and you're going to clip the side like this. And what that's going to allow you to do is maneuver it easily and put it in your lamp to cure it level. Right? So it's like the greatest hack ever. So get it to where when you set the clamp down, your ring looks nice and level. And then go ahead and fill that in with some resin. Because we're going to make a matching set here.
Same level, about halfway, you said?
Yeah. So we're going to let that level out too. Then we're gonna place our eyeballs in. All right, put that there. Just a little bit. Perfect. All right, so we're just going to do a variety of eyeballs because these are so cute. I made some barrettes with these. They're absolutely adorable. Who doesn't like little googly monster eyes? And I'm literally just gonna put one in the middle of my bracelet. Now you can cure the resin before you put your clay in if you want. It's totally up to you. It really comes down to personal preference. It will still cure all the way because it's going to cure all the way around, so you won't really have to worry about it too much, but if you want to work in layers, you can. How cute is this? This clay literally does last forever. If you do little projects like this, like one thing of clay will last a lifetime. So of course I'm gonna make my ring match. So I'm gonna do three little eyes because two would make too much sense for it to be spooky. So I'm gonna do three. Perfect. Okay, so that looks really good. So once you feel like it's leveled out nice, then what we're gonna do is bring our lamp over to the piece. Pieces, it's pieces, I guess. So I am gonna actually cure this above, quite a bit above these pieces. And we're gonna cure this at the same time. That way you guys can see how to clean your tools. All right, so I'm gonna turn this on and I'm gonna hold my lamp above my pieces like this. And what that does is it allows for the heat to escape a little quicker and it will allow it to have a much nicer finish. So when you're working with jewelry, if it's backless especially, you wanna make sure that you're curing it a little bit farther away because it lets the heat escape, it causes less shrinkage, you'll have less restriction lines, it works really well. So we are gonna go ahead and cure it. You can go, oh my God, I love this. Let me show them this really quick. How adorable is that? This is her ring. So she's making a Jack Skellington ring. Oh my God, I love it so much. That is amazing. Okay. So we're gonna do this one more cycle. And now that we've done one cycle with it above, we're going to just go ahead. you gotta watch the magnets, guys. So this is a great way to see if your stuff is cured. It's just curing your extra resin. Now I usually like make a pair of earrings or something with this, but see how clean my cup is? It's beautiful, beautiful thing. All right, so here's my little ring, super cute. And here's my little bracelet, super cute too. Because the blank has metal on the back, you don't have to cure all the way through. It's just important that you don't use too much glitter because you want that light to be able to penetrate through all of that resin. So just don't use like a super dark, heavy glitter. Just make sure that it's something that you can still see a little bit of that resin. So now the goal is see how beautiful this bracelet looks. It's just gorgeous. This is the look that we want for our bracelet and our ring. So I'm just gonna make sure that this is nice and level before I start my pour. That looks pretty darn good. And then I'm gonna make sure that my tool is clean as well. So I am going to clean this with just a little bit of alcohol because it's got some leftover glitter on it. You can use packing tape too. All right, so we're gonna do our ring first because that'll be our easiest win. So I'm just gonna scoot this bracelet over a little bit. We're gonna take our UV resin and we're just gonna add right to the middle. I always add it to the middle and then work it to the edge. So about a pea size and a half is what I would start with. And then use your brush and just very gently work it to that seam all the way around the ring. Now you can hold your ring if you want, I usually do, because then I can know that it's majorly level and it's easier, but in order for you guys to see it, I'm just gonna keep it down here. So once you know that the resin has touched all the way around it, it will continue to level, but I'm gonna add a little bit of heat. So I'm gonna take my lighter and just give it a quick swipe right across the top. And then I'm gonna let it rest for a minute. That way, if there are any bubbles, they will rise to the top and be easy to eliminate. The rings and the bracelets, the clay, the glitter, everything you see here is all available on our website. So if you go to resinrockers.com and you go to the blanks section, that is where you'll find all the jewelry blanks. We have hundreds of different like jewelry, especially all of the bracelet blanks. We have earring blanks, we have rings, we have bezels, we have backless bezels, we have the little bar pendants, pretty much anything you can possibly think of in our shop. All right, so this looks really good. The most important thing is making sure that you let it rest long enough. And we're gonna do the same exact thing to get that really nice glossy finish. We're gonna cure from the top and just from a distance, give it some of that UV light. And we're gonna do this for one cycle, and then I'll be able to sit this down and do another cycle. All right, so my cycle here is about done. So now I'm gonna go ahead, I'll cure it this way so you guys can see. I'm gonna go ahead and start this over. We're gonna give this a cure, and then I'm gonna do one last top coat on it to give it the round texture, or texture, the round look. So I'll show you guys a close up so you can see how gorgeous. This is made from our Sparks collection of glitter. Isn't it so pretty? I love this. I made this a long time ago, but I really love it. So in order to get that really nice shiny finish, you just want to make sure you're taking your time with the cure. All right, so let's go ahead. We're going to add our last coat. It's going to be so cute. Oh my gosh. So we're going to add just a little bit more to the middle. And this is the most important coat. And because we don't need a lot, you're only going to do about a pea-sized amount for this one. I will show you a close-up of this ring when I'm done and the other one so you can see how high. Because that's one of the reasons you don't want to bathe your resin in warm water if you're going to be doing the doming coat, because the more heat that you expose the resin to, the runnier it's going to be, which is great for casting, but for something like this, you want it to be a little bit more viscous. You can warm it up some, but not too much. So now that I've got the resin all the way around touching the seams, I'm gonna add a little bit more to the middle, one drop at a time, and see how it levels out. I'm gonna use my lighter, and that looks really good. So I'm gonna let that level for a minute. All right, so I'm gonna cure this one a little bit from top to tippy top. So now I'm gonna go ahead and give this a final cure. We're just gonna run it for about 30 seconds under the lamp at full wattage. Okay, so this is done. My ring's done. Oh my God, it's so cute. Okay, let me give you a close up first. Can you see it? Look at that shine. Oh yeah, baby. So that's my little monster eye ring. So I'll put it here at an angle so you guys can see it. Now we're going to do our bracelet. So the bracelet is going to match. All right, so let's go ahead and we're going to do the same thing, only these blanks are smaller. So we're just going to do one pea-sized drop on each eyeball. And they'll level out on their own, but we'll give them a little nudge with our silicone brush. Now remember, you can always add more resin, so it's always better to start with a little bit. Less is more when it comes to the doming part, which is the last step. All right, so now I'm just working my resin around, doing the same process as I did for the ring, just so that it's touching the edge all the way around. And then I'm going to use my lighter and just make sure I don't have any surface bubbles. You don't want to use the lighter too much, because what happens is it warms up the resin. So then, you know, it's going to be more runny. You'll have more runoff. So you just have to, you know, be frugal with it. If you notice that it's getting close to one edge, just tip that side of the blank back to the other direction. You'll be fine. But this looks pretty darn good. It's always helpful too to look from the side. So this looks really good. So I'm just gonna add, I see a one little spot that's a little low. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of resin. So we're gonna add a little bit more. And we're gonna let that level out, and then we'll cure it from above. I'm gonna spin this around because it's easier to see what I possibly could have missed, if any. We're gonna cure from the top. Freeform just released their 31 days of Halloween.
Oh, fun.
I love that because I don't have to think about it. I just go home, I can turn it on, and it's something Halloween related. All right, now we're going in for the full cure here. So let's take a peek, and then I will show Liz's after. There's my beautiful eyeballs. So cute.
That is
now,
very cute.
You can go higher. If you want to go higher with the round, which I probably will because that's how I roll. But super, super cute. And how easy is that?
Okay, so here is my ring. Super cute. That green looks amazing.
Oh, I love that.
So good. And then my
That's
bracelet.
So cute!
I'll just show it on the mat here.
It's so cute. There's the eyeballs. So there's that. And here's Liz's. And see how quick and easy that project is? It's so easy. Oh yeah, the charm! Duh! Okay. Here is your, let me give you your bracelet back.
Okay, thank you.
And here's your ring. We have our charm that we're gonna add. So we are going to need our pliers. So I don't know if you guys have ever used one of these before, but this is a jump ring tool. It's a ring that you put on and you just put the jump ring into this slot, and there are two sizes, so if you have a big one or a small ring, you just put it in here and you can take your little angled pliers and then bend it open like this, and it just makes it 10 times easier and faster if you're doing a lot of jewelry at once to go ahead and open it up in theory and put your charm on, and then you just add it wherever you want to your bracelet. I'm going to add mine right here at the clasp.
Oh, I like that.
And then you just put it into the little slit again. And you can do a bunch of different charms too if you want. Like, we have tons of different charms if you want to do that.
Yeah, it'd be fun to put one like in between each or every other.
You can do that too if you want. So we did a spider because it's Halloween. We have pumpkins, spiders, we have all kinds of fun stuff. Perfect! Look at that! We are the champions.
We did it.
Well, you guys enjoy your night, and we'll see you back on here sometime tomorrow. You guys have a great night.
Bye, guys.